Alright, what's up, dudes? This is going to be a vlog, of course. You may be able to tell I'm in my car. We're going on a little road trip this weekend, y'all. So come along for the ride. There is a purpose to it, but I don't think I'm going to go ahead and disclose what it is yet. All I'm going to let you guys know is that we're currently, road tripping it. So, I'm actually on my way to Chris's house. Of course, Chris is coming along with me. And, of course, I'm in my 2013 Honda Accord. And my other car, my 1990 Honda Accord, Chris is going to be driving that. We're going to be going tandem to our location. Now, you may be asking, why the hell would you do that? It just wastes a bunch of gas anyway. But there is a purpose to it, as I alluded to before. So, again, I will reveal that as time goes on. But, yeah, for now, all you need to know is that we're going on a pretty lengthy road trip, and it's going to be, it's going to involve both cars. So, sorry for the sunlight and the crappy video, but this is a vlog, so what do you want? Anyway, yeah, I'm going to go ahead and just make my way to Chris's house, and then I'll update you guys from there, I suppose. All right, I made it. Of course, there's the car. And, made it to Chris. I'm gonna go knock on the door now, because he's not answering his text, so. All right, so I'm still in my car. We just wasted a couple hours. We were at the car dealership, because something I left out of the previous clip is actually, Chris unfortunately totaled his car. Yeah, he got into a wreck last Sunday, and that's why he's driving my other car right now. So we were just at the local Mazda dealership trying to figure out, you know, what he qualifies for. But basically, we've determined that it's probably a better idea to not finance a car and instead just wait for the insurance payout and just buy whatever he can with that. So that's probably what he's going to do. Anyway, he's here. He's got to go fill up the other car with gas, and he's trying to wait for a package and stuff. So I'm just going to make my way down there myself, and then Chris should be not far behind me. So should be good to go. But yeah, I'm going to start heading down there. I have about 190 miles to go to the destination. I have to get to the hotel by 3 so I can check us in before they give our room away. So that's what I'm going to do. All right, so I just wanted to take a minute to go ahead and just appreciate this. I mean, look at this. This is fucking beautiful. Just driving through this and, you know, just blasting the stereo and just relaxing. This is literally heaven for me. I fucking love doing this so much. I mean, wow. This is great. I'm about 104 miles from my destination, and Chris is still, I don't think Chris has even left his house yet. He's still waiting, or I think his package finally showed up, so he should be heading out here pretty soon. But yeah, he's definitely gonna be behind me because I'm almost there pretty much. It says I'll be there at 3:30 and it is 2 o'clock right now. So yeah, I'm getting there. But yeah, I just wanted to take a minute to go ahead and appreciate the awesomeness that is driving this freeway. This is the 101, in case everyone is wondering. It gets pretty close to the coast towards the end of the trip. I definitely want to drive all the way down to Santa Barbara just so I can drive that strip of road, because it's right next to the ocean and it's beautiful. But yeah. Okay, I'm about, well, let's see here. How far out am I? 61 miles. I'm 61 miles from my destination, but I need to stop and go into Starbucks and use the restroom. But yeah, and also give the car a break. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that now. Much better. Now it's time to hop back in the car and make the final leg of the trip. And there is the California coast. This is probably the best section of the road. Well, the better section is going from where we're gonna be staying at, which is in Buelton or Santa Ynez, however you say it. From there to Santa Barbara is a beautiful drive. You're right next to the coast the entire time, but this is pretty close. So yeah, again, just love this road trip so much. This road is amazing. Well, I just made it. So, wow, I guess my door wanted to close itself. But yeah, I just made it to the hotel. I'm gonna go see if I can check in and make sure my room is actually reserved. So I'll be back. Also, this place is in the absolute middle of fucking nowhere. But I guess that was the point. So, yeah. All right, and here we are. Here's our hotel room.
Of course, this is a Motel 6. I moved the car over closer to the room itself, so we don't have to walk so damn far. But anyway, yeah, this is the room. So, not too bad there. Pretty decent. It was about $140 for two beds. So, yeah. Typical hotel room, basically. But a lot of people, like, you know, I've said Motel 6 is kind of crappy, but I don't know. So far, I don't really agree. I mean, I've only been here for 20 minutes, but this does not look bad at all, really. But, yeah. I'm just going to, I did get the optional Wi-Fi, and I'm just gonna set my laptop up right here and probably entertain myself. Chris is definitely on his way. He sent a photo, but I'm not exactly sure where he is. But, yeah. And again, as you may be able to tell, this is kind of in the middle of nowhere. But I mean, that's the point. I'm used to living in a big city, and you know, I wanted to get away. So I'm definitely doing that. All right. So I got my, I'm in the hotel, as I mentioned before, but I got the Wi-Fi. I decided to go for the free, or well, it's not free. It was $3, but I got the Wi-Fi just so I can have a computer to use. And yeah, so now I just gotta sit here and wait, entertain myself until Chris shows up. I think he's a little over halfway here. He might be closer now though. It's been a little while since I talked to him. So yeah, of course, there's the car, safe and sound. And then I'll probably tell Chris just to park next to me here. So yeah, there you go. All right, so he showed up finally. Yeah, so of course he brought my other car. So there they are. But now we need to figure out what the hell we're gonna do as far as food goes, because I'm about to like
commit a die.
Yeah, I'm about to like chew my fingers off. Starving, man. But yeah. Oh, by the way, how was the drive?
Uneventful.
Oh, really? All right.
Short of a BMW brake checking me, and I got to test the brake response at the Accord.
Did it work?
Well, obviously, if it didn't, I wouldn't be here.
Well, you never know.
Yeah, it worked.
In case anyone is misinformed or, you know, not in the know, the Accord has a little brake issue now. The master cylinder is going out.
It's only the master cylinder.
Yeah, it's only the master cylinder. It's no big deal. Basically what happens was when you're at a stoplight, according to Chris, because I haven't driven the car since it presented this issue. But according to Lay Chris, when you stop at a stoplight and you sit there for a couple minutes, the pedal just slowly sinks to the floor and then the car will start rolling again.
It's actually intermittent. Sometimes it happens, sometimes it doesn't.
The seals in the master cylinder are probably just wearing out.
Well, like, yeah, I mean, it's probably the original part. It's like almost 300K.
Yeah, and almost 30 years old, so not surprised, but we need to get that fixed. It should be okay though. I mean, he made it the 200 miles down here from his house.
It's basically a straight shot on the 101.
Yeah, literally, you get off the 101 and you're here. So, yeah. I drove down that way a little bit and just to see what was down there, and the answer is not a whole lot. So, now that's why I want to go to Santa Barbara tonight. So, yeah.
Also, because you guys are probably the first to see it.
Oh, yeah, the iPhone SE, which was actually Manly's, wasn't it?
And Manly's, I bought it off of him because, well, I'm buying it off of him because I was going to trade somebody for an iPhone. My old iPhone 6S Plus, and they bitched out. They know who they are.
Right. So,
I wanted an iPhone for iMessage because, as you'll probably see in my vlog clip, the reason people will probably ask if they, is you'll get yours up first. People ask, why do you drive?
I haven't specified the reason yet.
I will do it now.
Okay, alright.
Okay, there's a reason I drove the Accord here because my Mazda got in a wreck.
Well, I mentioned that, yeah.
And because some asshole brake checked a Nissan Pathfinder that was in front of me, so I ended up hitting him, and he took like no damage. My car's entire front end got smashed.
The whole front end of his car got wrecked. I mean, of course, I expected that because crumple zones, but it's still very unfortunate that he just got this car 6 or 7 months ago and it's totaled.
Yeah, 7 if we round up.
But. Yeah, so yeah, that car's totaled, as I mentioned before.
The good thing is the insurance valued it actually significantly more than it's actually
worth. Right, so he's getting a big insurance check and he's going to try to figure out what to do as far as another car goes.
So, yeah, so yeah. If you know me from the GFY or any of the groups Ryan has, you'll probably, this is old news.
Yeah, basically everyone that we talk to knows about it. But anyway, yeah, that's why we're driving these two cars. There's also another reason, as I, you know,
said before in the video, but we'll reveal that tomorrow when it actually happens. So.
Oh yeah, you guys are in for.
You guys are gonna like this, I think. But
I'll drop a hint though. It involves DOS Dude 1.
Yes.
Not physically. He's not here.
It involves Colin. Yeah.
But you will know. You will know what we mean.
Exactly, yeah. But as of right now, I think we're just going to drive to Santa Barbara, which is like 25, 30 miles away, and go try to find somewhere to eat that's not in the middle of butt fuck nowhere. So, yeah.
Hey, don't you talk bad about Billiton. It's where Anderson's the best. I've never been to Anderson, so...
Nah, this is a quaint little town. Just, you know, there ain't much here.
There's nothing here, and we would probably die because there's no Best Buy or anything for us to waste money.
Exactly, there's really nothing for us here. But anyway, it was a hotel and it was cheap. So yeah, anyway, we're gonna figure out what to do from here. Guys, like, he used to be in our vlogs like years ago. He's actually back in the States for a couple of months, so probably within the next few weeks we're gonna be meeting up with
him.
Yeah,
which is how I got this, because, you know, he's here.
Exactly, yeah, he sent this to him from up north in Concord. So yeah, we're gonna be hanging out with Manly.
He sent it from the Philippines, man.
No, but we're gonna be hanging out with Manly probably in the next couple of weeks or so that'll be cool. So, I'm having Chris video, but, I mean, just look at that fucking ocean, man. We're about, I think we're like 30 miles from Santa Barbara.
And before somebody's like, I can't see
Miata.
Hi, Matthew.
But yeah, there, I mean, look at that fucking, look at that view. It's beautiful. This is exactly why I drive.
It's like an emerald blue.
Yeah, it's not like the murky brown that we have up north.
It's brown. Look at the sea. It's brown.
As you can see, the wind is blowing my car all over the place, and my windshield needs a little clean. You may be able to tell, but that's what. Let's see how far we got. 261 miles so far. That's actually not that much, but you know, it's a road trip. But yeah, we're just heading to Santa Barbara because there's more people there and there's more shit to do. So we're probably gonna find somewhere to eat real quick, and then, I don't know, explore the city or whatever.
Then go die.
Yeah, dude.
Oh, wow. Yeah, that's
there you go. Yeah, that's really nice.
Eat!
Yeah, there's the hills, the clouds, all the wonderful shit.
Nature, man.
Nature, man.
Alright, so, we've arrived at the Chick-fil-A, which I actually haven't been to in a long time. So, yeah, of course, we're in the lovely Santa Barbara. Of course, we couldn't afford to live here or anything, but, you know, yeah. So, on the way home, we decided to stop at the beach because, I mean, why would you not? Look at this. This is just awesome. Sorry about the wind noise, by the way, if there is some. It's a bit windy out here. But, yeah, this is really, really nice. I'll just use my iPhone though, it has a pretty good camera. So, yeah. See, we got to pick up some water so I don't die tonight, but we brought the 1990 Accord. Seems to drive all right. Still drives actually really good for the age and condition, but yeah. Saw to do it. Back to the hotel, chilling.
Paint me like one of your French.
How did I know you were going to say that?
The funny thing is I totally was not intending for that to happen. Like, I was not intending to be in this position. I'm just like browsing Facebook, eating basic bitch Funyuns.
I kind of like knew in my head he was gonna. I was hoping you were gonna say
I
that.
I was trying to beat you to the joke.
Yeah. Yeah, but anyway, we're just gonna chill. And, yeah, that's about it for today. So hopefully tomorrow actually goes as planned, because if not, it would suck. But, oh well. YOLO. See you guys tomorrow. Alright, so it's the next day. We went to go pick up, you know, what we were gonna pick up, and I guess we'll reveal it now. As you may be able to tell behind us, we got a shit ton of vintage Macs.
Pretty much.
So this car, the 90 Accord, is pretty much full, and my car is not, but I have basically all the monitors, and then he has all the computers. Just to give you kind of, well, I guess I could just show you guys. Hang on. In the back here, or not. There. Okay. My bad. As you can see in here, we have a couple 2CIs. Well, we have a few of those actually. Got some Quadras, got some Performas, and a shit ton of like software and mice peripherals, that kind of stuff. You want to pop the trunk real quick?
Yeah.
This door is sticky. Nice. Anyway, as you can see here, here's more. Bunch of keyboards, 3 duo docks, which is kind of cool, and then, well, yeah, there's another duo dock there, ton of keyboards, and then the rest of it is basically just cables and hard drives and stuff like that. And then of course in my car we have a bunch of monitors that you need to use these computers, and a ton of printers. So that's about it. But we're actually gonna try to get home. It's like, so I think it's only like 9 o'clock.
Yeah, it's 8:53.
Yeah, so we'll be home pretty early, and then we can start playing with this stuff. So we'll see you guys when we get back to Chris's house. We lowered the 90. So yeah. No, but actually, I actually do want to do that at some point. But yeah, she's squatting a bit because of the weight. My car is too, but you can't really tell because, you know, my TPMS light came on, which was kind of stupid. But it's not direct TPMS, so it's probably wrong. I checked all the tire pressures and they're good. Except for that one. That one's a little low. Well, it's at 33 and the others are 35. Anyway, it should be fine. We're going to go to Jack in the Sack and eat some breakfast. All right, so here we are with DOS Dude 1 and Everblack.
Hello, mate.
Hello, mates. But yeah, DOS Dude 1, aka Colin, is the one that found us this deal, so yeah. But, we kind of forgot to make a clip of all this stuff while we were doing it, but now we have everything laid out and we can go through it all, as you may be able to tell. And yeah, we can tell you exactly what it is. So, of course, we got a shit ton of Macs. The first being this Macintosh Quadra 700, which is the best machine out of the, well, kind of the best machine out of these. Some of them have more RAM and stuff, but actually I think this one has the most RAM, but it, yeah, I guess this is the best one. So yeah. This one is the one we have up and running right now. It's running macOS 8. It has 68 megs of RAM and a 250 megabyte hard drive. As you can see, we're using a adapter cable so we can use a modern monitor, because this monitor works, but it looks like crap. And the other 3 monitors we got all don't work. At least we don't think so. So, yeah. Of course, we have Apple extended keyboards. We got a ton of mice. Of course, yeah, again, more keyboards there. We have 5 Quadra 610s or Centra 610s, they're pretty much the same. We're not sure if any of these work because they don't have hard drives or RAM in them, so those are kind of in the questionable category. Of course, we have 1 2SI here, and then 3 more over there. So that's cool. And then we have a 2CI and another Quadra 700, which also works. So that's cool. And then we have 2 Power Macs, or Power Macs. We have 2 Macintosh Pluses. This one doesn't work. It has bad solder joints. And then the other one, I think, is pretty much the same story. Actually, I think this one lit up. It just, you know, we can't use it, obviously. This one has the System Saver fan on the top, which is cool. And both of these are probably going to go to Colin, you know, if he ever makes it out to California anyway. I will have them in the meantime. Another monitor here. We have another Macintosh. Well, this is the only Macintosh Performer, actually. This one doesn't work, unfortunately. This is actually the only machine out of the bunch that doesn't work, so that's cool. And then we also have these you know, adapter cards. We got 5 of those, you know, pretty much brand new in the box, so that's pretty cool. Let's see what else we get here. We got a ton of software that I'm not really gonna go through because Chris went through it, but yeah, we got a ton of that stuff. We got an absolute ton of mice. Now let's see what else. These are microphones. These are the Ethernet adapter cables, so we can hook these up to the internet. There's literally a whole box of them, so that's cool. These we haven't looked at yet. We think these are hard drives. We haven't tested these yet, but we'll get to that eventually. Over here in this box, we just have more cables, you know, ADB cables and such. These are interesting. I'm not even sure what those are. That looks like a pair, or do you know what this standard is right here? What is that again?
SCSI.
SCSI, okay, yeah. I guess that's portable SCSI.
Showing your age.
Yeah, basically. And then look at all this software. It's pretty crazy. So, yeah. And then we also got a bunch of these printers, but we're probably not going to do much with these. They're printers. They're not that exciting. Over here, we have a ton of hard drives and optical drives. So that's cool. We'll have to test these eventually. And, yeah, that's about it. A bunch of IEC cables there. And the cars, of course. And then, of course, we have three Duo docks over here. So that's interesting. We don't have any power books, so unfortunately, we can't really test those or anything. But yeah, that's our haul. So that is pretty much it for now. I kind of went through everything that matters. So we're gonna probably get back to testing some more stuff as time goes on. So what are we doing?
We are right now. Because we got one of the hard drive enclosures up and we are kind of triaging each drive. But due to the way it has to determine the SCSI ID of these drives, it's not exactly reliable because it depends on the pin header that only exists on quantum drives. So we kind of have to just go try them. If they don't work, well, I'm putting them aside and I'll test them later. But I'm marking them off here, as we can see with the make, the size, and what interface it's using. We're just putting them over here.
Right, we're just trying to get organized here, basically. But I took a quick overview of what we got, but I mean, like, I'm just gonna go over it again, because there is just, I mean, look at all this software. This is all Microsoft stuff right here, but this is like Microsoft Office and stuff. There's just so much stuff. Like, it's really unfathomable that we got all this stuff for free. Of course, we have some printers over here. Style riders and stuff, dot matrix, of course. We haven't tested any of those yet. Not sure if we will, but yeah, bunch of cables. I've never seen, where's that box? I've never seen so many of these mice in one spot before. I mean, just look at all these mice. There are just so many. So, yeah, it's really cool. Like, of course. And then, yeah, I don't know if we went over which ones work, but I guess I'll do that again. So this one is the Quadra 700. This one works. Most of these work, actually. The only ones that don't work, I guess that would be the better way to do it, is the only ones that don't work is this Performa 475. This one definitely, it doesn't work for some reason. And then that CD, I guess, thing doesn't work. And these monitors don't work, unfortunately. And these two Mac Pluses, one of them turns on, I believe. The screen lights up and it has a floppy, you know, a flashing floppy. So that one seems to be okay. But one of them has bad solder joints. I think it's this one that needs repair. As you can see, it says Colin on those, because I'm probably going to save these for Colin and just hand those off to him if he ever comes down to California, that is. These work. I think some of these were part of a school, fleet, because one of them has like some preschool software on it. But yeah, the three of these work. That 2CI works, but it doesn't have hard drive and RAM. And then all of these Quadra 610s and stuff, these don't have hard drives or RAM in them, so we haven't tested those yet. And as you can see, we have these, NuBus adapter cards that go in here. So we got five of those, like pretty much brand new in the package, so that's kind of cool. And then we have some of these external drive enclosures, like the one he has over there. So yeah, like those. So it's basically just a SCSI enclosure, but yeah, pretty cool. You want to see a vintage hard drive? Well, there it is. Look at how thick that thing is. Holy shit.
I'm just trying to get to the floppy drive.
I think you have to remove this whole enclosure. Did you take the screw out?
Yeah. I'm just seeing to make sure it's plugged in.
I thought Colin said it was a pain in the dick. Well, hey, Hector.
Well, we're gonna take one for the team right now.
Yeah, we're gonna stick a floppy drive in there. Mine needs a floppy drive too. Mine doesn't even have a floppy drive, and the one that's in this machine doesn't work. So, yeah. So we took the good old 90 out to go buy some new batteries for the couple of the Macs, just so, you know, we could save some settings. But yeah, these were like $6 a piece, so we didn't buy a crap ton of them, because that would have been like
way too much money in batteries, but this is gonna go over the garage. The road trip kind of took a toll on my car, well, in my other car, but yeah, this is kind of a bug hell, basically a bug graveyard. Same with this car, it's just, you know. Yeah. As the garage is now open, so we can now install these. Saw, dude. And we're gonna install these batteries, and we're also going to probably try to install floppy drives into these Quadras. That way we'll have, you know, good machines.
So I couldn't write on these gigs.
Ooh, yeah. Whoa. The Wiener slider.
Alright, I am back at my house now. I brought the Quadra 700 up with me. Oh, my bad. Well, that sucks. Yeah, I brought the Quadra 700 up with me, and I also have the Macintosh Pluses and one of the 2SIs in my trunk, and all along with some keyboards, some peripherals, and, you know, other things like that. But I brought this one up with me. I'm just gonna set it up in the corner over here, just because why not? But yeah, that's pretty much gonna wrap up the vlog. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I had a lot of fun anyway, and you know, computers are always cool, and I know you guys are always wanting more tech videos, so this should fit the bill. Anyway, thank you guys for watching the video, and I'll see you guys later.